Chris, and you're watching an RTC Channel 4 presentation of Indiana High School basketball. We're getting ready for the opening tip-off. Valley will start off with the ball. Valley coming in this game 2-4. Witco coming in this game 4-2. Cameron Parker for three, and that's good.
Cameron Parker for three.
First points of the night for Valley. Go from beyond the arc.
Valley foul number 22, DJ Heckman.
DJ Heckman called for his first foul of the night. Two-point attempt is up. That is no good. Parker on the rebound. Doozy able to get that one back. Craig inside looking for two. That's no good. That'll be out of bounds on Witco. Valley coming in this game after losing to Peru 54-70. Valley is 0-1 in conference play. Witco coming into this game after losing to Wanwasee 54-47. That one was in double overtime. This is a Three Rivers Conference matchup. Two-point shot, no good. Parker able to come up with the rebound. Craig went through his fingers. Two-point attempt is good.
Nate Walpole.
Number 23, Nate Walpole for the Wildcats. Jared Dusenberry inside, and he'll get two. Valley with a 5-2 lead here early on. And that shot is good there again by Nate Walpole. Witco now within one. Craig jumps, no good. Doozy able to save it, but Witco comes up with it. Craig got a hand on it. And that'll go back to the Vikings. Craig for two again, and that one's gonna go in and out. Easy 2 points there for number 24, River West, for the Wildcats. And Witco will take the lead here. That will stay with the Vikings. Keith Wright thought about three, decided to give it to Craig. Craig will go for three, and he'll make it. Valley now with an 8-6 lead here. Well, that's going to be a foul on Alec Craig. That'll be his first of the night.
Brian Collins reports in for the Wildcats.
That shot is no good. But River West will be at the line as Keith Ryan picks up his first foul of the night.
River West at the line for Wildcats, shooting two.
West will be shooting two for the Wildcats. Looking to tie this game up at eight, he'll make the first one. This one will tie it up at eight. Looking to set something up here. Keith Wright for three. That is no good. Doozy with the rebound. He'll put it up. That's no good. Doozy took a hard fall there. That's going to be taken. They're able to keep it in bounds, but they gave it to Witko. Both Sean Heckman and Jared Dusenberry went for it at the same time. Long three-point attempt. That is good. Number 23, Nate Walpole for the Wildcats. Now the Wildcats with a three-point lead here with just under two to go in the first. Craig inside. Finds Doozy. Doozy puts it up, and that'll spin right in. Two-point attempt is no good. Heckman on the rebound. Craig for two. That's not going to go. Two points there for number 33, Spencer Schroff, I think. Not sure about that last name there. Oh. Doozy for two. Witko looking to hold here for a final shot to end the quarter. Two-point attempt, no good. Craig gonna throw it up. Oh, almost made that. And at the end of one, Tippecanoe Valley is down here as Witko leading 13-12. Alec Craig leading Valley in scoring with six, followed by, Dusenberry leading Valley with six. Craig and Parker both have three for Valley. Witko will have the ball here to start the second quarter. That shot attempt no good. Three-point attempt is blocked by Deshaun Heckman. Heckman got a hand on it, but it's going to go back to Witko. Three-point attempt is up, and that is good by number 24, River West. Witko now with a four-point lead here. Doozy inside, looking for two, and he'll get it. Valley now within two here. Three-point attempt is up, and that is good by number 30, Brian Collins. Craig not able to get it. Craig will head to the line for Valley. Craig will be shooting two for the Vikings. He'll make the first one. And he'll make both. And that's going to be a travel call there, and it'll go back to the Vikings. Witko leading here 19-16. 6:13 to go here in the second quarter. Deshaun Heckman for two, and he'll get that.
DJ Heckman.
Under six to go. Score is Tippecanoe Valley 18, Whitco 19. Make that 21. Valley now down by three. Keith right inside, and he'll get two. Right just snuck right inside the paint. No one saw him, and he got two. And that's going to be a foul there on Whitco, and it'll go back to the Vikings.
Offensive foul number 23, Nate Walpole. Colin Craig enters for the Wildcats. Timeout, Whitco.
Whitco calls a timeout here as they are leading 21-20 over the Vikings. 5 minutes to go here in the first half. Jared Dusenberry leading with 8 points. Craig with five. Cameron Parker with three for the Vikings. Our cheer block getting in the Christmas spirit. Everyone wearing an ugly Christmas sweater and jamming to some classic Christmas tunes. I like to say we have the classiest cheer block in the state, as they always bring the spirit to all our games. Valley will have the ball here again, down by one as Whitco leading 21-20, just under five to go here in the second half. Heckman inside. Craig will go inside now, and he'll get two. Valley will retake the lead here. Valley 22, Whitco 21. Three-point attempt. That is no good off the back iron. It'll go to the Vikings. Valley coming in this game is averaging 50 points a game. Whitco averaging about 65. Again, this is a TRC conference matchup.
Foul
number 11, Colin Craig. And Deshaun Heckman going to be called for the travel. Bad mistake there by Heckman. That's going to go out of bounds off the hands of Whitco.
Alex Bechtel reports in for the Wildcats.
Coach Patrick has not made any substitutions so far in this game. Right for three, and that's going to go in. That'll give Wright 5 points on the night. Not even now, they put it back in.
Spencer Schroff.
Number 33, Spencer Schroff. Deshaun Heckman for two, and that's no good. Valley will have the ball. Valley again will have the ball. They're leading here 25-23, 2:36 to go in the first half. Doozy for two, and that's going to go in. Valley now leading here 27-23. That'll be 2 points there for number 24, River West. Deshaun Heckman for two, and that's going to go in. Valley here with a 4 point lead. 1:50 to go here in the second quarter. And that shot put back up by number 33, Spencer Schroff. That'll be 2 points for Witco. Valley still leading here 29-27. 1:20 to go here in the first half. Craig going inside, lost the ball. That'll go back to Witco, 103 here in the second quarter. Valley leading 29-27 over Witco. Two-point attempt is up and good by number 23, Nate Warpole. We're tied up here at 29, 30 seconds to go in the first half. Valley gonna hold for a final shot here by the looks of it. Under 10 to go. Doozy lost the ball. That's going to be an open lane. That'll be 2 points there for Alex Bechtold. And that'll be the end of the second quarter. Witco is now leading 31-29 over Tippecanoe Valley. And we'll be right back after halftime. And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, as we're getting ready here to start the second half. Whitco is leading Tippecanoe Valley 31-29. Jared Dusenberry is leading Valley with 10 points, followed by Alec Craig with 7. Keith Wright has 5 for the Vikings. We're getting ready to start back up here. Still no substitutions for Coach Patrick's team. We'll see if that strategy pays off for him here tonight. Valley will start off with the ball. Doozy inside, no good. Two-point attempt is up, and that's no good. Cameron Parker on the rebound for the Vikings. Doozy gonna shoot for 2 and he'll make it. That'll tie this game up here at 31. 3-point attempt, long one, no good. With under 7 to go here in the third. Valley is not going to take the lead. So we'll stay here at 31 apiece. Valley going to try it again. Doozy inside, finds Parker. Parker gonna shoot, and that is no good. Still tied up here at 31. Doozy's gonna pick up a foul there.
Nate Walpole playing for the Wildcats shooting 2.
Nate Walpole at the line for the Wildcats. Whitco now leading here by 1, 32-31. 6:15 to go here in the third. That's going to be a travel there on Deshaun Heckman. Still Whitco ball, 2-point attempt, that is good by number 33, Spencer Schroff. Schroff. Heckman inside and leaping over. And he's going to head to the line for two.
Wildcat foul number 11, Colin Craig.
Whitco leading here 34-31. 5:29 to go in the third. Heckman looking to make this a one-point game. He'll make the first one.
Alex Robbins reports in for Whitco.
Heckman looking to make this a one-point game. And that he does. Whitco now leading here
34-34. Cameron Parker
going to pick up his first foul of the night. Nate Wolpole will shoot two for the Wildcats. He's going to make the first one. That'll make this a two-point game.
Brian Collins reports in for the Wildcats.
35-33. Coach Patrick still has not made a substitution tonight. That might start taking its toll on some of these Valley players as Wolpole will make the second. And we're back to a three-point game here. Whitco 36, Tippecanoe Valley at 33. And that one is good there by Keith Wright, which will make it now 36-35. Under five here to go. Now we're going to be gotten a hand on there by Doozy. Craig with a three, and that's going to go in, and Valley will take the lead here, 38-36. That's the second time Craig's made it from the arc this evening, as three-point attempt there, no good. And that's going to go out of bounds. It's going to go to the Vikings.
Alex Spector reports it for the Wildcats.
4:27 to go here in the third. Valley leading 38-36. Keith Wright inside. Wright gonna head to the line for two.
Whitco foul number 24, River West. Keith Wright at the line for the Vikings.
Valley leading by two. And that's going to roll off. No good on the first one. Whitco is going to call a timeout. Valley leading here 38-36, 4:17 to go here in the third quarter. Jared Dusenberry leading Valley with 12 points, followed by Alec Craig with 10. Keith Wright has 7 for the Vikings. Coach Patrick still no substitutions. As Keith Wright is at the line, looking to make his second basket. This will make it a three-point game. And he'll make it. Valley now leading here 39-36. Witco able to regain the ball. 2-point attempt is up, and that's no good. Craig on the rebound, and Wright's open for the easy 2 points. Now Valley leading here 41-36. That gives Wright 10 points on the night. And that one's going to roll off, no good. Under 3:30 here to go in the third quarter. Craig finds Wright. Cameron Parker for two. Valley starting to move ahead here now, 43-36. Three-point attempt, that one is good by number 23, Walpole. Nate Walpole. Cameron Parker inside, easy 2 points there. Well, I have a timeout on the court here, Tippecanoe Valley leading 45-39 on top of Witco. 2:34 left here in the third quarter. Jared Dusenberry again leading Valley with 12. Keith Wright and Alec Craig both with 10.
The Witco Tippecanoe Valley girls basketball game that was scheduled tomorrow evening has been moved to 2:30 tomorrow afternoon, starting with the JV game. The time changes due to the weather reports this Saturday evening. Please stay tuned for further developments due to the weather situations tomorrow. In case of weather postponement, listen to WRSW 107.3 radio or WROI radio 92.1.
And still no substitutions for this Viking squad. All five of these players have been in the whole game. And that attempt does no good. Foul is on Deshaun Heckman.
Number 22,
that's his second foul of the night. Alex Bechtold at the stripe for the Wildcats. And that'll go in. 5 point game here. 2:19 to go in the third. Misses the second one. Doozy on the rebound. Doozy for two, no good. 3 point attempt, that one no good. I think Wright may have got a hand on that one. And it'll go back to the Vikings. 1:45 to go in the third, Valley leading 45-40. Craig for two, and that's no good. And that'll be 2 points there for number 23, Nate Walpole. Valley still leading here, 45-42. Alec Craig inside, and he'll get two. And he's going to head to the stripe.
Winco foul number 23, Nate Rockwell. Colin Craig reports in for the Wildcats.
Craig looking to make this a three-point play. .108 here in the third. Valley leading 47-42. Is Craig not able to make the extra point? Walpole, no good on that one.
Winco foul number 33, Spencer Shrug.
Just under a minute to go here in the third. Valley still leading here 47-42. Wright thought about three, decided not to. Cameron Parker for three, and that is overshot. Final seconds here of the third quarter. Witko shoots a three, no good off the front. Puts it up, and that's no good. So at the end of three, Tippecanoe Valley leading here 47-42. Jared Dusenberry and Alec Craig leading Valley with 12 points, followed by Keith Wright with 10. Again, no substitutions so far in this one. All five of the starters have played every minute of this game.
The boys' varsity basketball team will be in the casting tournament December 29th and 30th. The first game on the 29th is at 6 o'clock against Oregon Davis.
And again, still no substitutions.
Possession Witko.
Witko will have the ball here to start the fourth and final quarter, that is, unless this game goes into overtime. All five of Valley's players have played in all 24 minutes with no substitutions. So we'll see if that will affect these players here in the fourth quarter. That's going to be a foul on Jared Dusenberry. It'll be Dusenberry's second foul of the evening. Valley leading here 47-42. Dusenberry will pick up his third foul of the night. And that'll be 2 points there for number 11, Colin Craig, for the Wildcats. That'll be a foul there. Heckman will be at the stripe for Valley.
Winco foul number 24, River West. DJ Heckman at the line.
Thank you. Heckman will make the first one. Valley leading here 48-44, 7:28 to go here in the fourth quarter. Heckman looking to make it a five-point game, and he's not going to be able to. .48-44 is the score, Valley leading. Two-point attempt is no good. That one gonna go out of bounds. Keith Wright for two, and that's no good. Three-point attempt, no good. That's going to be a foul on Witko.
Witko foul number 11, Colin Craig.
And Colin Craig calling for his fourth foul. He'll have to be careful as to not get fouled out for the Wildcats. Valley still leading here 48-44, 6:30 to go here in the game. That one's gonna roll out of bounds. Valley will have the ball. They're all over Heckman, and they're going to come up with it. And that'll be 2 points there for number 23, Nate Wolpel. Now it's a two-point game. Valley 48, Witko 46. They're all over Craig that time. Doozy inside for two, no good. Parker on the rebound, looking for a place to go. He'll put it up himself and he'll get two. Great job there by Cameron Parker. Valley now here, leading 50-46, 5:20 to go here in the fourth. Wright gonna take it and he's gonna go up for some easy points. That'll make the score 52-46 as Tippecanoe New Valley will take a timeout here. 5:12 remaining on the clock. Keith Wright, Alec Craig, and Jared Dusenberry all lead Valley with 12 points apiece. Followed by Cameron Parker with 9. And Deshaun Heckman with 7. Valley again leading here 52-46. 5:12 remaining. Still no substitutions for this Valley squad, and well, right now it seems to be working for them as they're leading here 52-46. They don't seem to be showing any fatigue so far. Nice backward Shot there by number three, Alex Bechtold. Witco now within four as Parker better find a place to go, and he finds Wright. Wright for two, and that'll go in. Valley leading here, 54-48. That'll be a travel call there, and it'll go back to the Vikings. Great call there. Craig jumps for two, and no good. Three-point attempt is no good. Doozy on the rebound. Under four to go here. Valley still leading 54-48, and Dusenberry lost the ball, so Witco will have it, and Craig denied that pass. That shot good there by number three, Alex Bechtold, and timeout on the court here is Valley leading 54-50. 3:39 left on the clock. What a great game we have here for you tonight. And what fitting music that is there as the band plays the Imperial March, especially with the new Star Wars movie out. That's right, Rogue One, now in theaters. So I've heard some good reviews on it. So if you ever get bored on your Christmas break, might as well go see the new Star Wars. Parker for two, and not able to get it. And that'll be 2 points there for number three, Alex Bechtold. Now Witco within two, under three to go here in the game. Valley leading 54-52. And that's going to be a foul there. Good call by the officials.
With the foul, number 30, Brian Collins.
Deshaun Heckman will be at the stripe for the Vikings. 2:47 to go here. Valley leading 54-52. Heckman shooting one in the bonus. And he'll make the first one. Makes it a three-point game here. Heckman looking to push it to four. That he does. Valley now leading here 56-52, a 2:45 left on the clock.
40.
That'll be a foul on Jared Dusenberry. Doozy's going to have to be careful here as he has four fouls. Nick Woolpole at the line for the Wildcats. And he'll make that one.
Alex Roberts reports in for Whitco.
Coach Patrick might be thinking to make a substitution here, as I don't think Valley wants to lose Doozy here if he gets fouled out. Parker inside, looking for a place to go. Craig almost lost it, but it's going to be a foul.
Spencer Schroep.
Craig will be at the stripe. 2:25 left on the clock. Valley leading 56-54.
Alec Craig at the line for the Vikings.
And Craig will make the first one. That'll put this at a three-point game. Valley leading 57-54. Craig looking to make it a four-point game, and that he will. Timeout, Tippecanoe Valley as they're leading here 58-54. 2:25 remaining here in the game. Alec Craig and Keith Wright leading Valley with 14 points apiece, followed by Dusenberry with 12. Both Deshaun Heckman and Cameron Parker have 9 for the Vikings. Still no substitutions made in this game. And that strategy seems to be working for the Vikings as they're leading by 4. Whitco will have the ball here. And that's going to be a travel call, and it'll go back to the Vikings.
Alex Roberts reports in for Whitco.
Craig for 2, and he'll get it.
Alec Craig.
Great play there by Craig, and now the clock is under 2 minutes to go. Valley leading 60-54. Three-point attempt is up, and that one is good there by number 23, Nate Walpole. Three-point game here. Valley leading 60-57. Deshaun Heckman at the line for the Vikings.
Brian Collins reports in for the Wildcats. DJ Heckman at the line.
Valley leading here 60-57, 1:35 left on the clock. And Heckman gonna make the first one. We're back to a four-point game here, 61-57. And he'll make the second to make this a five-point game. timeout, Tippecanoe Valley.
30-second timeout, Tippecanoe Valley.
Valley leading here, 62-57, 1:35 left on the clock. Alec Craig leading Valley with 16 points, followed by Wright with 14. Jared Dusenberry has 12. Heckman has 11. And Cameron Parker with 9. Still no substitutions. You just gotta hope that fatigue doesn't become a factor here in the final minute 35 in this game. This Valley squad seems to be holding on here. His long three, put it, that one is good there by number 23, Nate Wolpel. And this is the point in the game where it all comes down to will. Who has the more will? As Jared Dusenberry goes in there for two. 1 minute to go here. Valley leading 64. Make it 64-62. And with 57.6 seconds left on the clock, Tippecanoe Valley leading here 64-62. Craig again leading Valley with 16 points. Both Wright and Dusenberry with 14. Again, no substitutions with under a minute to go here. Valley leading by two. Valley with the ball. Craig almost lost it. It's going to go out of bounds, and that'll go to the Wildcats.
Brian Collins reports in for the Wildcats.
54.4 on the clock. Valley leading by two. Three-point attempt, no good. That one no good. Wicco gonna keep the ball. Two-point attempt, that one no good. That's gonna go to the Vikings with 33.1 seconds on the clock. Valley still leading here, 64-62.
Wicco foul number 24, River West.
And Craig will be at the line.
Adam Craig at the line for the Vikings, shooting two.
Craig looking to make this one a three-point lead for the Vikings. That he does with that shot. Valley now leading 65-62, 33.1 on the clock. Now Craig looking to make it a two-possession game. And that he does. Valley now leading 66-62. Under 30 to go here in the game.
Valley foul number 22, DJ Heckman.
Deshaun Heckman call for his third foul. 29 seconds on the clock. Nate Wolpel at the line for the Wildcats. He does have the bonus. And he'll make the first one. 66-63 is your score. 29 seconds on the clock. Hale make the second. It's now 66-64. Timeout on the court. Valley leading here 66-64. 29 seconds left on the clock here, and I'm starting to get that overtime feeling. Valley is 1-1 in overtimes this so far this season. Valley will have the ball here. Craig going inside and not able to get it. Under 15 to go here. Valley leading by two. And now we have a tie ball game at 66. Tippecanoe Valley calls a timeout. 8.3 seconds left on the clock, and we're tied here at 66. Now, what a game we have here. Is this one coming down to the nail? We're tied here at 66, 8.3 seconds on the clock. Valley will have the ball here. Looking for a final shot. Craig for three. No good. And we're headed to overtime. This one tied up here at 66. So this one head into overtime as Tippecanoe Valley and Wico are tied up here at 66. Alec Craig leading Valley with 18 points. Keith Wright and Jared Dusenberry both with 14. Heckman with 11 and Cameron Parker with 9. Again, no substitutions in this game for the Viking squad. Hopefully fatigue won't start setting in here in the overtime period. Again, Valley is 1-1 in overtimes this season. Getting ready here for the tip-off of overtime. Wico will start off with the ball. 4 minutes to go. Dusenberry with the rebound. Oh, Craig inside looking for two, and he'll get it. Valley takes the lead here, 68-66. That'll give Craig 20 points on the night. Two points there for number 33, Spencer Schroe. Three minutes to go here. We're tied up at 68. Valley looking to set something up. Doozy going inside, and that one got tipped. And that is gonna be a foul on Witko. Dusenberry will be at the line for the Vikings. Witko fans not very happy about that, but nonetheless, good call by the refs. Doozy looking to put Valley in the lead here, and that he does. 69-68, 2:31 left here in the first overtime period. And he'll make the second. Now it's a two-point game, 70-68. And that'll be 2 points there for Spencer Schroer. Tied here at 70. 2 minutes to go here in the overtime period. And bad pass there by Parker as Doozy takes a hard hit to the wall. And Doozy seems to hit his back and looks like he might have to come out here as he's shaken up. He seems to be all right. We're tied here at 70, 1:30 to go. Two points, no good, but Parker, I believe, calling for the foul on that one. That'll be Parker's second foul of the night. Spencer Schwarz at the line for Witko. Tied here at 70, 1:10 to go in this one, and he misses the first one. Still tied here at 70. Missed the second, right with the rebound. That one gonna go back to the Wildcats. Bad mistake there by Craig. We're still tied at 70, 1:04 to go here in the first overtime period. And that's going to be a travel call there on Nate Walpole, and it'll go back to the Vikings with 51.5 seconds to go. Still tied up here at 70. Cameron Parker looking for a place to go. Under 30 now, still tied at 70. Valley needing to make a shot. And Keith Reich going to be called for the travel. I think there should have been a foul there on Witco, but I'm not in the stripes. Timeout Witco, as we have a tie ball game here at 70. 23.4 seconds remaining on the clock. Alec Craig leading Valley with 20 points. Doozy has 16. Keith Wright with 14. Deshaun Heckman with 11. And Cameron Parker with 9. No substitutions in this entire ball game for Tippecanoe Valley. And you gotta wonder if fatigue is starting to set in here. Makes you wonder if Coach Patrick will make a substitution. I'm gonna doubt it though. What a nail biter we have here. Tied at 70, 23.4 to go here in the first overtime period. Still no substitutions for Valley. I have a feeling these five boys are going to be tired in the morning. Under 10 to go, Witco with the ball, tied at 70. And that one is going to go to the Vikings with 4.9 seconds remaining on the clock, tied up at 70. Valley with a chance here. Valley takes a timeout here. Again, tied at 70, 4.9 seconds on the clock. What a game we have here. It's moments like these that remind me back in 2011 when Indiana played Kentucky and there was about 5 seconds left on the clock and Christian Wofford shot the three to win the game. And that's what I love about the sport of basketball, is those last second moments, as we might be seeing one here tonight. 2 seconds, Craig puts it up. Oh, not able to make it, and we're going to double overtime. Again, tied here at 70. Another 4 minutes put back on the clock as we've now entered the double overtime period. Alec Craig leading Valley with 20 points. Jared Dusenberry with 16. Wright again with 14. Heckman with 11 and Parker with 9. Still no substitutions for this Viking squad. Coach Patrick trying something new tonight, and it seems to be working for him as they've stayed in this one. Witco lost in their last double overtime game to Wawasee, 54-47. Hopefully they'll have those same struggles here tonight so the Vikings can get a victory. We're getting ready here to start the second overtime. Tied here at 70. What a game we have had here so far. Valley will start off with the ball to start the second overtime. Let's hope the fatigue is not a factor here in this one, as all five of these players have played every single second of this game. Cameron Parker shoots for two, and it's going to roll off. Parker able to keep it in bounds. Valley have another chance here. Heckman goes up. And it's going to go in, and he's going to head to the line to shoot one. Or never mind. No, he's not. I thought I saw a foul there. They didn't call it. And that'll be 2 points there for Nate Wolpel as we're tied again here at 72. Well, hold on. I haven't been paying attention close enough, I guess. They didn't call Deshaun Heckman's shot good, so Wico now leading 72-70. Doozy inside looking for two, and that's going to go in. We're tied at 72 now. 3 minutes to go here in the second overtime.
Foul number 22, DJ Heckman.
Heckman called for his fourth foul, and he's going to have to be careful. Both Heckman and Dusenberry have four fouls. Wolpel makes the first one. It's a 72-73 win. Excuse me. Getting tired here, folks. 72-73 lead here for Witco. Misses the second. Keith Wright has it. Craig inside and not able to get it. I think there should have been a foul there, and they're not going to call it. And Ekman's going to come up with it. Craig goes up. He gets two. Valley leading now 74-73. 2:10 on the clock. Craig now with 22 points. And it's going to be a travel call. It'll go back to the Vikings. Valley with a 1 point lead here, 74-73. 2 minutes remaining here in the second overtime. Parker is open. He should have shot it, but he didn't, but he'll get that one. Valley now 76-73. Under two to go here in the game. That's going to be a foul there on Cameron Parker. It'll be on Heckman, and that's Heckman's fifth, and he's going to have to come out of this one.
Alex Roberts reports in for the Wildcats.
Coach Patrick figuring out who he wants to put in, and Wes Melanson will come in for Deshaun Heckman. First substitution of the night for the Vikings. Valley leading here 76-73, 1:44 remaining here in the double overtime period. number 24, River West, at the line for the Wildcats, and he'll make that one, make it a two-point game. West looking to make it a one-point game, and he does. Valley leading here 76-75. What a game we have here. And that one, bad pass there by Parker. Witko will have the ball. Not able to get it. Parker with the ball. He's going to go. He's going to keep it in bounds. And that's going to stay with the Vikings. Valley leading here 76-75, 1:14 left on the clock here in the double overtime. That one tipped, and Witko going to have it. That's going to be a foul on Craig, I believe. That it is. That'll be his second of the night. Nate Wolpole at the line again for the Wildcats. And we're tied up at 76. 109 remaining here in the double overtime. I think the fatigue might be starting to set in here for the Vikings as he misses the second. Melanson able to keep it in bounds. Tied here at 76. 1 minute to go in the double overtime period. Valley going to try to hold onto the ball as long as they can. They're all over Parker. Now they're all over Craig. Craig just running around with it here, trying to waste some clock. Melanson inside. Finds Wright on the outside. And now under 20 to go, tied at 76. Valley going to hold for a final shot here, try to win this one in double overtime. Craig finds Wright for three, and he's not able to make it. Puts it up, no good. And that will be the end of the double overtime. And now we're going to triple overtime as we're tied up here at 76. What a game we have here for you tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Alec Craig leading Valiant, scoring with 22 points. Dusenberry with 18. Keith Wright has 14 for the Vikings. Gonna get ready here for the third overtime. Tied up here at 76. So another 4 minutes put up on the clock. No substitutions. Wes Melanson still in for Heckman, who fouled out earlier in the double overtime period. And that'll be 2 points there. Number 33, Spencer Schroe. Witko now leading 78-76. And Witko going to have it again, and they're not going to get it. Number 24, River West, at the line for Wildcats. Craig called for his third foul. And I think the fatigue might be starting to set in here. And he'll make the second one. It's a 3-point game here, 79-76. Valley down by three here, 79-76, 3 minutes to go in the third overtime. Doozy inside, not able to get it. Melanson couldn't put it up either. It's going to be a foul.
Witko foul number three, Alex Spector.
Wes Melanson is at the line for Valley. He'll make the first one. That's actually Melanson's first varsity point this season. And what an important point it is. Not able to make the second. Witko leading here, 79-77. Make it 81-77. 2:23 remaining here in the third overtime. And I hate to say it, but I think that fatigue's starting to set in as Valley now making crucial mistakes. Now it's 83-77. 2:05 on the clock. And I don't think this Valley team was prepared for three overtimes, as the strategy of keeping all five players in the whole time is starting to become a problem. Keith Wright will be at the line for the Vikings.
Valley pop foul. Witko foul number 23, Nate Walpool. Keep Wright
at the line. And Keith Wright not able to make the first one. Witko leading 83-77, 1:51 remaining here in the third overtime. He'll make the second one. Timeout on the court. 1:51 remaining here in the third overtime. Witko leading 83-78.
Green and gold.
Again, 151 remaining here in the third overtime. Whitco leading 83-78. An up and down battle we've had here tonight. That'll be a travel call there, and it'll go back to the Vikings. 1:39 on the clock. Doozy inside, not able to get it, but Doozy's going to head to the line for two. And that'll be the fifth foul for Spencer Schroe, so he'll have to come out for the Wildcats. And that could be a difference maker here, as Schroe has 14 points for the Wildcats. He is their tallest player, so that could be a factor here in the final minute 34 of this third overtime, as Dusenberry will make the first one. 79-83 your score. And he'll make the second. It's a three-point game. Wicku leading 83-80. 1:30 to go here in the third overtime. That's going to be a kick ball on Keith Wright. Whitco takes a timeout.
Timeout, Whitco.
With 1:15 left in the third overtime, Whitco leading 83-80. Alec Craig leading Valley with 22 points, followed by Dusenberry with 20. And Keith Wright has 15 for the Vikings. Whitco will have the ball here. That's tipped. Dusenberry has it. Under a minute to go. Dusenberry is going to get two. It's a one-point game. Whitco leading 83-82. Under 50 seconds here in the third overtime. That's going to be a foul on Keith Wright, I believe. That it is. That'll be Wright's second foul of the night. 47.4 on the clock. Whitco leading 83-82. Nate Wolpuk at the line for the Wildcats. He'll miss the first one. Wolpuk has 39 points for the Wildcats. Great game he is having. He'll make the second one. It's a two-point game, 84-82. Valley will look to hold for a final shot here again, most likely. That's going to be a foul there. Doozy will head to the line to try to tie this one up.
Lincoln foul number three, Alex Bechtel. Jared Dusenberry, the line, shooting two.
84-82 is your score. And it's gonna get the lucky win push there. 84-83 is your score. 39.5 seconds on the clock. Doozy gonna try to tie it up here at 84. And that he will. We're tied at 84. 39.5 seconds remaining. What a game we have here. Tied at 84. Under 30 to go. Hopefully that fatigue on Valley is not gonna be a factor. Craig gets the ball! Craig gets the ball! He goes up for two! He gets it! He gets it! 86-84 is your score here. Valley with a 2-point lead. 9.4 seconds on the clock. Valley with the timeout here. 9.4 on the clock remaining here in the third overtime. Tippecanoe Valley leading here 86-84. What a game. Craig now with 24 points, as does Jared Dusenberry. Wright again with 15. And it's moments like these that are the most enjoyable. You gotta love these moments in Indiana basketball. Valley has the ball. 9.4 seconds on the clock. They're leading by two. Quick fouling there by Whitco. Craig at the line for Valley. 8.5 on the clock now. Craig shooting two. Misses the first one. If Craig can make the second one, it'll make it a 3-point game, which will make it very hard for Whitco to get it. He'll do it. Whitco calls a timeout, 8.5 on the clock. Tippecanoe Valley calls a timeout. Valley leading here 87-84. Never mind, it was a Whitco timeout. What a game we have here. Craig with 25 points, Dusenberry with 24, Wright with 15. And Valley with a 3-point lead. 8.5 seconds on the clock here in the third overtime. Whitco is gonna have to make a three, which is gonna be very hard, especially with the short time limit here of 8.5 seconds. I tell you what, folks, I've got goosebumps. What a game this has been. Whitco has 8.5 seconds to make a 3-point shot and tie this one up. If this was any other state, I'd say it's impossible, but this is Indiana. Anything can happen. Three-point attempt is up. He made it! Oh, my goodness! Final seconds. Craig did not get the shot off. We are tied here at 87. And now we're in a fourth overtime. What a game. What a shot there to tie that one up. Another 4 minutes added onto the clock. Tied here at 87 points. 4 minutes now on the clock for the fourth overtime. I've got goosebumps, let me tell ya. Tied here at 87. 4 minutes here in the fourth overtime. Not very many basketball games go to four overtimes. This one has. Neither team willing to give up here. Now I have a feeling this is going to be the most exciting 4 minutes of tonight. Valley will start off with the ball. Under three to go now. Valley trying to hold onto the ball as long as they can. Craig looking to go inside, decided not to. Now one gonna go out of bounds, still Valley ball. 2:01 here, still tied at 87. Craig going inside. Melanson finds Wright, right for two, and that's in and out. Duesenberry with the rebound. Ah, but Wicko's gonna come up with it. Craig has the ball, finds Wright. Wright goes up for two. He gets it. 1:25 to go here in the fourth overtime.
Wes Melanson
call for his first foul of the night. We'll pull at the line for the Wildcats. He'll make it. Valley leading 89-88. To 1:22 on the clock. He misses that one. It's a one-point lead here for Valley. Jump ball. It'll go to Witko. 1:20 now on the clock. Valley leading 89-88. Three-point attempt. No good. Craig with the rebound. And now Valley will just try to hold onto the ball as long as they can. 1 minute to go in the fourth overtime. Valley with a one-point lead, 89-88, 50 to go. Craig goes up. He got two. It's a three-point game, 91-88. 40 seconds on the clock. I think they're going to call that one on Doozy. That they are, and Doozy is going to have to come out of this game as that's his fifth foul. And you got to hope that's not going to hurt the Vikings. Coach Chad Patrick getting his dad away from getting a technical. Alex Morrison gonna come in for Valley now. Walpole at the line shooting two, 38.4 on the clock. Valley leading by three here. He'll make the first one. It's a two-point game, 91-89. And this Walpole kid is having a great night as he has 45 points in this game. He'll make the second, 91-90. Tanner Tripedi now coming in for Valley. Third substitution for the night for Tippecanoe Valley.
Timeout, Witko.
Witko calls a timeout. Timeout. 38.4 seconds here remaining in the fourth overtime. Valley leading 91-90. Alec Craig leading Valley with 27 points. Valley has the ball here, leading by one, 38.4 seconds on the clock.
Yeah.
Heaves it over to Parker. Parker has it, able to hold on to it. And now Valley will try to hold on as long as it can. Wright is at the line. 33.5 seconds on the clock. Valley leading 91-90. Wright makes the first one, 92-90.
Alex Morrison reports in for Tippecanoe Valley.
Alex Morrison now in for Valley. If Wright can make this one, it could be a big difference maker. He does. 3-point lead for Valley. 30 seconds to go in the fourth overtime. They cough it up. Craig has the ball. Alec Craig gonna head to the stripe. 19.7 seconds on the clock. Valley leading 93-90. Craig shooting two. And it's now a 4-point game. Craig can't make the second. It's a two-possession game, though. Time is not on Witco's side. 3-point attempt is up. It's no good. Goes for two. That one's good, but I think it's gonna be too late. And there's going to be a foul.
Witco foul number 24, River West.
Keith Wright is at the line for the Vikings. 2.7 seconds on the clock. Valley leading 94-92.
Keith Wright at the line for the Vikings, shooting two.
Wright makes the first one. It's a 3-point game. 95-92. 2.7 seconds on the clock. If he can make this one, this game is over. He makes it. I'm going to have to say that neither team is willing to give up here. And that's what you like to see out of your high school players. 2.7 seconds on the clock. Valley leading 96-92. Alec Craig leading Valley with 28 points. Keith Wright has 21. What a game we have here. Witco has the ball, 2.7 seconds. I do not think that they are going to be able to pull this one off. Final seconds, throws it up, misses, and Tippecanoe Valley will win this one in four overtimes, 96-92, and what a game that one was. And that's going to be the bottom line because the scoreboard says so. I'm Chris Seacrest, and you've been watching an RTC Channel 4 presentation of Indiana High School basketball. Good night, folks.